So I am delighted to introduce our honoree tonight, Bayo Ogunlesi. So Bayo is the perfect honoree because in many ways, his life reflects the American dream that America needs to work so hard to support. Let me explain. So he comes from Nigeria, goes to Oxford and then Harvard. He becomes a Supreme Court clerk for Justice Thurgood Marshall, practices law at Cravath, becomes global investment banking head of Credit Suisse, and if that's not enough, then he goes and finds his own private equity fund, which is called Global Infrastructure Partners, and serves on some boards that you may know of called Goldman Sachs and many others. Now, I've heard a rumor that he also was an astronaut in the space for a couple of years, but I can't verify it, so I'm not going to put on the list, Bayo. Now, more important than his achievements are his contributions. When New York Needs You was just an idea, no mentors, no fellows, just a lot of passion and a good piece of paper, you know, he wrote the first check and helped us get through, you know, our first couple months. It was a big check. And you know, he was supportive to not just myself, but many of my friends, my colleagues, and young professionals. In my own experience, when I came to him with a crazy idea to start some technology, real estate, brokerage company, Urban Compass, most people said, that's crazy, but he supported it. And he became not just an investor, but an advisor, and helped us get to the success that we have today. At America Needs You, there's a saying we have, which is, may your dreams be your only boundaries. You know, Bayo, whether it's with myself or many others around him, has had a long tradition of opening doors, breaking down barriers, and making it easier for people to realize their aspirations. He's an incredible philanthropist, a respected leader, and a lifelong friend. So without further ado, I would like to introduce America Needs You's 2014 honoree, Bayo Ogunlesi.
Good evening. Thank you, Robert. And I'd like to thank the leadership of America Needs You for this incredible honor. You have in your program the list of people who've gone before me, and so it's sort of the good and the great, and then there's Bayo. Okay. It's funny, when Robert called me to say, would you accept this award, he had this really rather long speech that he had written, okay, and he started to go through this, you know, campaign as to, you know, why I should do this, and I said, fine. And he didn't stop, he kept going, you know, and I said, Robert, I said, fine. And, you know, the one good thing is to see Robert actually at a loss for words. It was just, I thought that was incredible, okay? Now, what he did not tell me was that standing up here, being expected to give some remarks, after the extraordinary fellows who have spoken, that was Robert's revenge. So I salute all the fellows who have, you know, had tremendous accomplishments, as all of you have heard, in the face of, you know, tremendous amounts of adversity. I thank all of you for your generous support, which makes the work that America Needs You do, which is very important. I thank you for your generosity, and I encourage you. You know, the lines are still open, so please send your texts. And as Robert said, he first introduced me to this organization, you know, sort of 4 or 5 years ago before it got started. And for me, it has been a pleasure and a delight to watch the organization grow and to see what was once New York Needs You become America Needs You, and hopefully with your support extend to Philadelphia, Chicago, and other cities. Because quite frankly, what America Needs You does is the challenges that it addresses are beyond New York City alone. Now, there's a lot being said these days about income inequality. as diverse a group of people as Pope Francis, President Obama, Speaker Boehner, as well as our new mayor, have all talked about the rising income gap and inequality. Imagine, to the chagrin of all, as I think all of you know, the great and the good, or many of the great and the good, are gathered in this small town in Switzerland called Davos, where they sort of discuss the fate of the world. And usually, there's a group of people who are there to protest against all the plutocrats who they think are gathered in Davos. And I think much of the chagrin of the protesters, the theme, the key discussion point at Davos this year is actually income inequality and what to do about it. Now, clearly, there's a lot of things that governments can do. There's a lot of things that businesses can do about income inequality. What I find most refreshing is an organization like America Needs You that is focused on three things that can make a huge difference in addressing the income gaps in this country. One is education. Clearly, education provides you with skills. It provides you with a tremendous amount of, you know, ability to tackle and solve problems. Hopefully, it inspires you with a love of learning. It inspires in you the discipline and of hard work. It encourages curiosity, which, as I think many people know, is the fountain of innovation and entrepreneurship. Education is, I think, important. America Needs You focuses on that. It focuses on mentorship, right? Because what it does, it allows the fellows to understand that they are not alone as they try and navigate their way through life. That many of the challenges and the problems that they face may come up in different manifestations, but these are problems that their mentors have faced, and their mentors stand side by side with them to help think through how to resolve them. And I think most people who are successful, including myself, would admit that at some point in their lives, there have been people who have served as important mentors who've helped them sort of make progress. The final thing that America Needs You does, it talks about building networks and relationships. You know, success in professional success, it's about ability, it's about hard work, but it's also about relationships. Because at the end of the day, relationships really do matter. Who you know, how you connect to them, is an incredible determinant of how you succeed. So I find it refreshing that, in, you know, with all the talk about what governments can do to address income inequality, there is this outstanding organization that started in New York, has moved to New Jersey, hopefully will spread to the rest of the country, which does, in very tangible ways, help solve and address these challenges that our young people face. So Emilia and I are very proud to support the organization. As I said, I thank all of you for all of the support that you have provided. I encourage you to continue to be successful. And of course, I would not be, I would be remiss if I, you know, finish my remarks without thanking the person who for over 30 years has been my mentor and my coach, my wife, Emilia. Thank you, sweetie. Thank you for all that you do for me. Thank you for all that you do for our boys. Thank you for all that you do for our family. I thank the leadership of America Needs You. And again, please be generous in your support of the organization.